I love coffee, I love tea, I love the Java, Java, and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. I love Java, sweet and high. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee and pie. Shoot me the pot and I'll pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup. Oh, it slipped me a slug from that wonderful mug. And I cut it rug till I'm snug in a jug. A slice of onion and a raw one.
Draw one.
Waiter, waiter, percolator.
I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java, Java, and it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me. A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup, a cup.
Boston beans.
Sardines.
I said the little itty bitty green beans.
Cabbage and greens.
You know that I'm not keen about a bean. Unless it is a chili, chili bean.
Talk it, boy.
I love Java, sweet and high. Whoops, Mr. Moto, I'm a coffee pie.
Yeah.
You shoot me the pie, now pour me a shot. A cup, a cup, a cup of that San Marzo.
Ooh, slip me a slug from that wonderful mug. And I'll cut a rug that's snug in a jug. Drive your nickel in my pot.
Joe,
take it slow. Waiter, waiter, percolator. I love coffee, I love tea. I love the Java, it loves me. Coffee and tea and the Java and me.
Yeah.
A cup, a cup, a cup, a cup.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning. Here it is, Wednesday, July 7th. I hope everybody had a wonderful and awesome July 4th weekend. I was quite happy we had a little bit of rain here in the Seattle area. I'm sure the firemen were also happy. We're expecting to hear from Chris and John. You know, if you're like me, unfortunately, I hate to admit it, I never heard of them. When they contacted me by email this previous weekend, their producer, or one of their producers, I should say, contacted me asking if we'd be interested in talking to them here on Gay Talk Radio. And I said, sure, why not, after I find out what they were all about. Yeah, they're kind of a campy kind of duo that does... Oh, goodness gracious, they've done a lot of things. They really have. They've been doing TV up in Canada. They're both from Canada. They both went to college in the Toronto area up there in Canada together. And they both were in the, you know, the arts of dance and voice and production, TV production and whatnot. And yeah, they've got a new show coming out on Logo TV. Tonight is their premiere. It's actually a carry on from their previous formats, more or less. But it's a premiere for Logo TV. They have a television network up in Canada called Out TV, which they had been previously involved in. And today is going to be their first premiere showing of their new show that's going to be on Logo TV, which will appear tonight at 8 p.m. East Coast time, 7 p.m. Central time on Logo. Yeah, so you can check out their show. It's going to be pretty awesome. pretty awesome. I get all confused about all their different shows they've done now, but this newest one is going to be something special. If you might have seen the article I pasted on Queer Public Radio, it told a little bit more about it. It's Chris and John Go to Camp. They're actually, and that's a kind of a play on words, because they're campy in their own right. And in Michigan, there's a gay camp, a RV park slash tent park slash it's like an outdoor gay bar. It really is. They have events going on there, and at this resort, it's the Camp It Resort. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. In Saugatuck, Michigan, or in the general vicinity, it's a seasonal RV park slash tent camping. They got a pool, and they have events all lined up. Like, for, you know, they had July 4th events. I mean, you got to make reservations in this place. It's a pretty popular place. I was like shocked. You know, it's very, very popular, and it is a gay RV park slash camping site place. Yeah. I don't know, if I was in the Michigan area or traveling around in my RV, I'd definitely want to check them out, because it looks like a lot of fun, you know, because they got events scheduled for every weekend. They got drag shows. They got bears there on one weekend. It's really full of events. You know, it's like they schedule something for every weekend during their on season, I do believe. It's kind of like almost being like on a cruise, you know, like on a ocean cruise in an ocean liner or something, you know. Except it's an RV camp. It brings a whole new meaning. Yeah, they have cabins there and trailers and whatnot that people can rent out. Yeah, you know, so if you don't have your own RV or whatever, you can drive there in your car, you know, and they'll have a place for you to stay. You probably should make reservations, especially if it's on during any kind of holiday time. But it seems very, like they have a whole list of events, you know, going on at that place. I was kind of shocked when I looked at their website and said, wow. You know, I mean, it's like they have an entertainment coordinator going on and stuff. Pretty good stuff. So yeah, we're going to hear from Chris and John. At least that's as far as I know. We're going to just hear from Chris and John. Who knows? I they have a sidekick, goes by the name of Brian Doyle, and you know, we'll see who's on the line when they call in. That's all we got to do. They should be calling in here in a couple minutes. Yeah, I look forward to talking to them. But yeah, tonight, 8 p.m., and evidently they're going to have 8 episodes. They got lined up and ready to go, according to what it looks like. And so I'm guessing for the next 8 weeks, you can check out Chris and John. They are just wonderful and crazy guys. Yep. You know, and they, like I say, when they go Chris and John go to camp, it means more than they're just going to this RV resort to camp. It's, you know, the meaning, the word camp, you know, as in, you know, in the bar scene, you know, when people camp it up. So it's a double entendre there that we got going on, because they are all about camp. You know, we'll talk about more about it when they get on the line. But that's their whole thing. They're kind of kooky. You know, they're not really meant to be taken seriously, and you know, it's comical. It's satirical comedy. Yeah, and they take it to a whole new level. I don't want to get too much into it here, because I want to talk to them about it when they get on the line with me. It ought to be interesting, I think. Anyway, I'm looking forward to speaking with them big time. Oh, goodness gracious. They both come from the Toronto area. Let's see here. In the 1990s, they became best friends while attending the same drama, dance, and art schools in the Niagara region of Ontario. It wasn't long after that the two became best friends and started experimenting with the video camera, making short fan sequels to their favorite horror movies. The duo developed their signature quirky sensibility at a remarkably young age, including fundraising for animal shelters, concocting cakes made from crisp rice marshmallow squares, and invading local Polish festivals. I gotta ask them a little bit more about what's up with the Polish festivals when we get them on the line. What's up with the Polish festival guy? Oh, that might be them calling now. Let's see. Hello, welcome to Gay Talk Radio. This is Tom. Who am I speaking with?
Hi, yes, this is John Simpson from Chris and John Go to Camp.
Hey, you two, what's going on?
Not much. I think Chris is calling himself too, but I'm separate line. Are you able to patch two people on at once?
We should be able to, yes. We'll see what happens here. So we got you on one line and we're going to have Chris on another, huh?
Exactly.
Hey, that ought to work. I don't have any problem with that. So, John, you're calling from where? Where are you right now?
I'm calling from Toronto. Toronto, Canada.
Wonderful. Wonderful.
Exactly. We just had a big Pride celebration this past weekend.
Oh, awesome. Oh, that was
exactly. It was a lot of fun and craziness.
Yeah, that was in the news quite a bit, the Toronto Pride stuff this.
So, oh, really?
Oh, yeah. The little stuff that went on was some group that was kind of with the Israel thing, you know, and
right.
Yeah, I won't go into that too much. We don't want to get all negative. Oh, you two are a hoot, man. I have been looking at your
watching.
Oh man, I'm looking at your videos that you got all
great.
Over YouTube.
There's a lot of stuff on there from YouTube that's really old. So I'm really excited for everyone over there in the U.S. to see the new stuff we're doing. So.
Yeah, you know, it's that's good. It was funny because your producer, you know, when he first emailed me, he gave me this really, really brief.
Right.
Did he tell you what happened?
He did, yes, I will explain it.
I was thinking, now, this is a religious thing. Wait a minute here, buddy.
Exactly. He gave the description of how we're saving the world one gay at a time, but didn't really explain that what that meant exactly, how we're saving the world, which in reality it's because if you're single, we're going to set you up. If your house is haunted full of ghosts, we're going to rid your house of the ghosts, even though we have no idea what we're doing. Throughout the episode, basically, we're going to figure out how to do it, and we're going to make it happen.
And I think that's what's hilarious. Especially, oh, wait a second. I think we got Chris calling in here.
Amazing.
Oh, let's see. Is that you, Chris?
So is this, are we live to air right now?
Yes, we are live to air right now.
Oh, well, hello, listeners. It was so bizarre. I thought we were just sort of in a holding queue, but I guess we are live on the air, so I might as well talk and make it sound interesting.
John just hung up.
Well, you know, my name's Chris, and from Chris and John Go to Camp, airing tonight on Logo, 8-7 Central. And we're currently, I guess, trying to get my co-star John on the line as well. I know these call-in situations are awfully
okay. I think I got you both in there now.
Yeah, exactly. Hi.
I'm so sorry, John.
No problem. This has been good. John, you gave me the wrong number and you were a saboteur. I didn't mean to. I dialed that number first myself, and then as I was talking to you just now on the radio, then Chris, I text messaged him the right number at the same time. It was very complicated, but I'm quite crafty.
You are both quite crafty.
Well, thank you. So what did I miss? What's going on? I didn't realize that we were live on the air, and the whole conversation about trying to get you on back on the air, I was just kind of like, oh, okay, you know, we're waiting, we're hanging out, and I'm like, are we on the air? And he's like, yeah. I'm like, okay, well, I'm Chris from Chris and John Go to Camp, airing tonight on Logo, 87 Central. You might as well squeeze in a plug while you can, right? For sure. Just fill up the time, yeah.
You too. Oh, goodness. Yeah, I had to apologize. It was actually my fault for clicking the wrong button in the wrong place in the when Chris called in.
Oh, no problem.
Yeah, I goofed up.
We know these radio things firsthand. We had to learn how to do it ourselves, which was definitely an uphill battle for us because we're not very technically inclined when it comes to radio things.
Well, and I saw y'all are both tonight. You're going to be on another radio, LA Talk Radio or whatever, was it?
Oh, that was the other night. We were on that the other night.
Oh, that was the other night? Oh, okay.
Exactly. It was a couple nights ago, yeah.
Oh, okay. I got my nights mixed up on that one.
No problem. But yeah, we're basically publicity whore, so anywhere and everywhere we'll talk to, we'll do anything we can.
Awesome.
Get out there.
You two are a hoot. So you got 8 episodes lined up. This is going to be every week starting tonight. It's going to be the next 8 weeks.
Exactly. So all summer long, it's sort of the perfect summer reality show that you could ever ask for. And so every Wednesday at 8, you have to just keep tuning in. And a lot of things are really episodic, where every episode we do a new rescue mission, if we will. We go on a new adventure. But there's a lot of things that sort of threaded throughout the episodes, because basically the cameras followed our every move for an entire summer at this campground we went to. And so all our relationship problems and romances and stuff like that are all up there. And so now all of America gets to see it.
I think that's awesome because, you know, I'm jealous because Canada's been seeing you for years, and this is our first
chance. Exactly. We're super excited about it.
I mean, goodness, y'all started in what, 2005?
Yeah, I know. It's been 5 years. We started with a show called The Chris and John Show, which was a 5-minute interstitial program. So that was between regular half-hour shows on our Canadian broadcaster, OTV. We had this little, like, 5-minute, you know, very low-budget show that we just sort of threw together, and that evolved into a show called Chris and John's Road Trip, which led to Chris and John to the Rescue, and now we're here with Chris and John Go to Camp on Logo TV.
Yeah, man, I was like, wow, you know, yeah, I saw all that, Chris and John, and then the road trip thing, and then the Rescue, and you actually did 2 different seasons of Rescue, right?
Exactly, right, yeah.
And
this aired here in Canada under the Chris and John to the Rescue sort of name, and so now we're launching it under a whole new name and brand for the U.S. launch.
And you went to Provincetown during your road trip thing, right?
For one of the Rescue seasons, we went to Provincetown. The whole season we filmed in Provincetown, and that was an incredible experience, to say the least.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I got a little sound clip here from, I think it was when you were, what's her name, Deidre?
Yeah, Deidre, we rescued her.
Oh, yes, hold on a second now, let me play the little, because I think that's when you were in Provincetown.
Exactly.
Let me play this little sound clip with her. I got it off your YouTube video.
Great.
Hi, my name is Deidre. I'm a monogamous fag hag. I'm really hoping that Chris and John can help me find the fag of my dreams.
Well, given your criteria and your fabulousness, John and myself really think we can find you the perfect fag.
Good. Well, you better do a good job, because if you don't, you're going to suffer the consequences.
Oh my.
Oh my is right.
She was.
I guess for listeners, Deidre is. She's a very, very large woman. She's definitely very fabulous. So when you know she said you better do your best job, or else you're going to suffer the consequences. We didn't know what to think. So just to put some context for the viewers who can't see how amazing and large she is, that's she's just a really big lady. And those are the kind of things we do. She came to us. Her best gay friend moved away. And to quote her, she's a monogamous fag hag, and so it was our job to find her a new best friend. So the whole episode was about finding her a new best friend, and we narrowed down candidates, we advertised all throughout Provincetown, and then we brought them to her, and they each got to go on a date with her, and by the end, we crowned her a new best friend, and they're still great friends to this day. We actually just saw them this past fall when we were visiting Massachusetts.
Yeah, that when I saw that one, I was like, oh my goodness. Now, I had to wonder, I said, what's she going to do, sit on these poor little guys, you know? I mean,
it was a possibility. You'll have to watch the episode and see.
I mean, y'all trashed her to hell, man. I saw some other videos. She, like, I'll eat a fried fork you had on one of those, and I was like, oh my God, you know? I was cracking up.
Oh my God. I think the Five Forks one that she was you know, she has her own page on YouTube and she uploaded those videos. We definitely
yeah,
would
that was definitely her.
We personally love Deidre, so and she's yeah. We have another series, after Chris and John Go to Camp that we recently shot, and she's in that as well. So we brought her back because we just love her so much. And I'm not sure when or if or what, if that's going to go up on Loga, but hopefully, we're very hopeful.
You know, I gotta, you know, give y'all kudos too, because I read in the press kit that was sent to me that you've been nominated for Best Reality Program in 2008, the CFTPA Indie Awards, and then
the CFTPA is sort of like our producers guild, and our first season was nominated, so we're very, very excited about that.
And that even on the new Now Next Awards with Logo and last year you were the most addictive reality starts.
Exactly. That was so much fun. We got to go and hang out with all the Logo stars in New York, and we are very honored, to say the least.
And you know what? I mean, I found a little clip on that. And first, before I play this little clip, I have to apologize to Justin. And Justin is John's. Is he your husband now or still your fiancé?
Oh, I can't reveal these kind of things. People have to watch the show starting tonight to know what happens with my relationship.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry.
no problem.
Well, in the stuff I read, it said he was your fiancé. So anyway, it's online. Anyway, that y'all were living together or whatever, and that you had a dog.
Right.
And that he has a dog's health food store?
Exactly.
And I was like, you know, I had to put all that in. But I had to put the apology out to him. And that's why I was asking you. I was like, well, if you're not together anymore, I don't have to apologize. But since you won't tell me, I don't. You know.
So what are you apologizing for? What are you about to play?
Well, when y'all were at the new Now Next Awards party in 2009, there was a very short little tiny clip I found where the two of you talked with, I believe it was a gentleman by the name of Mike Diamond. Anyway, here's the clip.
Are you guys lovers?
No, not in any capacity.
A little emphatic, I think you are. So when you guys are like on the road, do you like drink a lot and then say, oh, okay, I guess I'll f*** you?
Actually, yes.
No! Yeah, thank you, Chris and John, to the rescue. Thanks, guys.
I mean, we get that a lot. Every time anyone sort of ever speaks with us, that's always the first question that comes out is, are you together? And we've tried to be as emphatic about it as we can to say, no, we're not. But, you know, when the question gets asked so many times, you know, it's like, you know, Kristen Stewart and that Rob Pattinson guy, you got to throw in some mystery every now and then.
I just thought, I loved John's reaction, you know, when he asked about if y'all were like, I mean, it kind of sounded like he was asking if y'all had sex when you go on these road trips and stuff.
And, exactly. Goodness gracious.
And, of course, Chris said, yes, we do. You know, and John fell out. I mean, no!
Oh, no. Sorry. Straight to Toronto. Well, I couldn't, like, just take a phone call in my office to go on the radio. What am I supposed to tell my coworkers? Hey, you know, good about to go on the radio. That's a lie. I totally did, but I decided to come outside just to get some fresh air.
Oh, and Chris, you know, I mean, I wasn't surprised at that because, you know, I'm sorry, Chris, but what are you, a heartbreaker? Come on now. I saw when you were in Provincetown, what was it, a guy named Tim in Provincetown, and then when you were at the camp at resort, there was Anthony, and I'm like, you heartbreaker.
Well, I mean, with Tim, because in Provincetown, I mean, it was a summer thing in terms of Chris and John at the Rescue, Provincetown, you know, our second season. we had this little fling going on, and then it sort of, you know, it ended, and you kind of see how that all evolves on the show itself. And then with Chris and John Go to Camp, I mean, something, you know, something else develops with this new guy named Anthony. But I mean, I wouldn't definitely say there's no necessarily heartbreak or non-heartbreak with Anthony. I mean, you'll just definitely have to tune in to find out what happens. It's very interesting and very new, and sort of a little bit different than what people normally experience when meeting Peter. Meeting these guys in like places that aren't where we live. So I mean, you met Tim in Provincetown, and I mean, you know, they tried to make things work, but the long distance thing was really hard. And so he does start seeing this guy Anthony, and Chris and John Go to Camp, you'll see tonight. And I think by the end of the season, you'll see Chris have to make some decisions on what to do with the fact that he's dating someone that doesn't live where we live. And so that's sort of really interesting, and everyone will get to see that.
Oh, that's cool. So that'll play out in the upcoming episodes too. Cool.
Exactly.
Oh, that's awesome. See, so now we're giving them food. Look, people, if you want to get the whole story, you got to watch.
Exactly. I think you'll really enjoy seeing him.
There's no excuses. This is, you know, the 21st century. You got TiVo, you know.
There's various ways to watch it, too. You can go into LogoTV.com. Allegedly, it'll be airing on LogoTV.com a few days after it airs on LogoTV. So we encourage everyone to tune in tonight at 8, 7 Central.
Yeah, really, for sure.
And it'll also be repeating a few times during the week, too, I think, if you miss it, but you shouldn't.
And you know, I got to give John kudos, too, because I think, you know, it. John, you're so nice of you to give Chris...
Yeah, Chris has sirens, but I'm here.
Okay. You give Chris top billing, you know? It's the Chris and John. It's always Chris and John, Chris and John. And I'm like, oh, what a sweetheart.
Exactly. Chris gets first billing, but, you know, what can I do? Because John and Chris doesn't sound like my name has an S on the end of it, and like if we ever wanted to do, like, we started off with, you know, Chris and John's road trip, and John and Chris's road trip just sounded too S-y. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I guess. I was thinking that, too. I said it kind of flows better, right?
Exactly. That was one of our most interesting episodes we've ever done of any of our series. So basically, there's a newspaper here in Toronto called Extra Magazine, and we went to them and said, you know what, we are like, okay, well, we know nothing about this, so we're just going to have to start from scratch. So we got online, did a little research, and we found out about something called the Gay Bear Film Festival, which is this weekend camp out in the middle of nowhere in Vermont. And so basically, Chris and I packed up our bags. We went with the production crew down to Vermont, and we sort of, like, blended in with the crowd, and we tried to get to know the gay bear community and what it was all about and what it means exactly. And so the whole episode is about us interacting with these bears, and we, in order to go to the festival, like, it's disguised as a short film festival, but really it's just like a festival with a hot tub and chili cook-offs and all those kind of things you could expect bears to do. But we did enter a film in the festival about gay bears, and we quickly learned that we were a little off in track with what we did.
We were very misguided with our film entry, and it causes definitely a lot of controversy. I think that's probably all we want to reveal, because it is very... very out there for us, especially because we were totally out of our element. I mean, we were, you know, we weren't even in a small town. We were just in the middle of the wilderness in Vermont. Like, we could have died and no one would have known.
So, imagine the first season of Chris and John to the Rescue. So definitely, definitely see that.
Yeah, that was hilarious. In fact, I got a sound clip from that, too. And,
you're amazing. I love you.
That was the most hilarious. I mean, that was the first one I watched, you know. And, I mean, I loved it when you guys were like, oh, and we got a film we made that we're going to put in your film festival, and it's going to be the best film you ever saw, you know. And you're telling this to the guy that makes his own films, you know. And, I mean, you know, I was cracking up. And then when the pig bit you or whatever happened there, and then when they told you the pig, you know, was going to be slaughtered and eaten, you know, I was like, oh. Anyway,
we're way off track.
Yeah, let me play the sound clip on this one because y'all kind of set it up pretty nice. Because I basically left all the stuff in the middle out, and I put like the very beginning when you go into the extra office and you're talking with whoever that gentleman is in there, and then the very ending where you did a little skit. This is kind of about 3 minutes worth here. Hope y'all don't mind. Is that okay with you?
No, that sounds great.
Sure. All right.
Enjoy.
Chris and John are about to take on a rescue mission unlike anything they've ever had to deal with before.
Hey guys, thanks for meeting me here today.
No problem. How are you today, dear?
Pretty good, but I'm in a little bit of a bind.
What is that supposed to mean?
We have a writer that's bailed on a story, and I need some help, and I need to get this assignment done.
Did he withdraw on account of illness?
No. Well, I want to do a story on gay bears in the gay community, and I'm looking for two writers, and I thought about you guys.
Pardon me?
Well, I want you to go out, and I want you to do a story on gay bears.
We're not in that type of category.
Very unprofessional.
It doesn't really matter. Reporters are good observers, and if you guys are as good as what I've heard you are, then you should be able to go out and do this story, even if you don't know anything about gay bears.
That's so racist.
Be creative, put yourself in as the person that wants to know about gay bears, and go out and do a story that explains what they are.
So how long do we have to work with here?
You have 2 days.
What are you, nuts?
That's more than most reporters get to write a story for extra. 2 days is plenty of time.
In a world obsessed with stout figures, flawless skin, and hairless bodies, there's a subculture that goes out on a limb and dares to defy the popular gay stereotype. We're talking about, of course, gay bears.
What are gay bears exactly and where do they come from? Though their exact origins are unknown, gay bears have been around for a very long time, perhaps even since the dawn of the gay man. Like their animal counterparts, gay bears are on the hunt, be it for love, for companionship, acceptance, or maybe just discreet encounters. These giant creatures will not go quietly into the night.
We, the mere culture aficionados, embarked on a mission to debunk the myth of the gay bear. Our mission led us to the Vermont Gay Bear Print Festival to observe the behemoths in their natural territory. Our attempt to blend in via a misguided entry in their film festival was met with great hostility. You see, we were just way off track with our preconceived notions of gay bears. And to set the record straight, gay bears don't eat babies.
What we learned was that maybe gay bears don't need to be put in a box, packaged nicely for the public to be able to point and say, hey, that's a gay bear. Maybe what this subculture needs is unity. To spit in the face of social conventions, toss out their razors, tweezers, and deodorant, and just be gay bears.
What we realize is that gay bears do just that. They don't care if their bellies hang low, if their backs develop into a bristling jungle of matted hair, or if they feel the need to grunt and whistle at any given opportunity. No, they don't care. And why should we?
To make amends with the bears over our misguided film entry, we wrote them a poem, an apology. Gay bears of the world, we love you.
And that, my friend, is the daddy. What'd you think?
I don't even know what to say, actually.
You know, we put ourselves out there, we got right into the depth of the story.
It's different than what we've often had here at Extra.
So what's your next big story? What's your next expose?
Your style doesn't actually fit every type of story we do, so I'll have to give it some thought. And sometimes a long, long time goes by before reporters get a second story, so...
What's that supposed to mean?
Don't call me. I'll call you.
Stay tuned for scenes for the next episode of Chris and John to the Rescue.
That was hilarious. I just loved it when he told you, well, your style doesn't fit.
Exactly. No. Every story they do there. No, exactly. We needless to say, we never got a call back from Extra again. Ain't that the truth?
It is. It really is.
Yeah, I guess we'd all be surprised if they ever called you again, huh?
No, exactly. They didn't at all. They sort of severed all ties with us, sadly, but we still love Extra. And that article was published, John Lena.
Oh, really?
Yeah, no, it was. Legitimately.
Oh, my God. let's see here now. Oh, I got one more clip here I haven't played, I think, and I don't even remember what it is, but it's from your Chris and John to the Rescue. But I can't set it up because I forget what it's about.
Well, know? Why don't we just throw caution to the wind?
Yeah.
And you can play it anyways, and then we'll talk about it after.
Yeah, and then you can tell us all about it. Let's see what it is.
Exactly.
Aloha.
Hi, dear. How are you today?
Okay, go ahead.
Here's the deal, y'all. The world needs us. We need to start immediately.
Pardon me?
The world needs us. We need to start immediately.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's true, lady. Well, you've been basking in the sun. I've been inundated with phone calls and emails from people who are in need of our unique services. It's our responsibility. Better yet, our calling to save the lives of people who otherwise might die heinous deaths.
What's that supposed to mean?
That means you have exactly 1 hour to get up, pack your bags, and join me on a rescue mission. We're saving the world, y'all. One gay at a time.
What are you, nuts?
Oh, and yes, hilarity will ensue.
Jeez.
See you in an hour. Bye, hon.
Oh, dear.
Meet Chris, eligible bachelor, jet setter, talking of the tabloids, and heir to a large discount food manufacturing conglomerate.
On paper, I don't really sound like a very giving or helping person, but I feel that everyone has the right to my opinion, and in that, they can enrich their lives.
Meet John, professional matchmaker, notorious potty boy, philanthropist, and canine enthusiast.
In terms of social activism, it's my personal goal to outdo Angelina. No, wait, that's a little off track. It's my personal goal to outdo Gandhi.
Last season, these two best friends hit the road for a summer-long road trip adventure of a lifetime. And now their new missions, rescuing people. And if I know these boys, things might not go as exactly as planned.
I'm really ready to lend a helping hand, and I think it'll be really fun to interact with locals who I'd otherwise avert my eyes from. But I know that if anything gets out of hand, I'll always have John there to take the fall.
Chris has been my best friend for like ever, so I'm so glad to be doing this rescue mission with him. I wouldn't want to be doing it with anyone else. Well, except maybe Sarah Michelle, a Buffy fame.
In terms of inspiration for rescuing, I really look up to Sarah Michelle. We saw her do it for 7 years on Buffy the Vampire Slayer, and I think it's my turn.
Together, Chris and I make a really good team, and I'm confident that all of her rescue missions will be a success.
Break leg, huns!
Yeah.
That was the very intro for Chris and John to the Rescue, the first episode where sort of that was just setting up the concept of me calling Chris and letting him know that people really need our help. And so that was us going on our first rescue mission, getting ready to go.
I was in Hawaii at the time when he called, and so when he's like, you know, I'll see you in an hour, I was just giving him a look like, what, are you crazy? Like, I'm on vacation.
It was I'm very demanding when need be, so I generally only have a time limit of an hour. I can't wait longer than that.
You know, and
I watch the show as sort of a running theme.
Yeah, that's what I like. You know, you're kind of, even though you got all these different names and all these different things, it kind of follows the same theme.
Exactly. It all sort of runs together, and people get to know our bizarre, quirky personalities, and we have a lot of things we like to say, and so people will hopefully catch on, and our lingo will perhaps start to become a teen trend across America.
And we try not to make things too based in stereotypes. It's really more based off of sort of our personalities and what we take from pop culture and how we just, you know, talk normally to one another, but amplified at obviously 1,000%. So we try not to be too cutting in terms of, you know, being stereotypical. We just want to make sure we're doing things that are us, but amplified.
And as you heard there, we talked about our love for Sarah Michelle Gellar of Buffy the Vampire Slayer fame, and that continues on in Chris and John's at a camp. We still love Sarah Michelle. She is our idol.
Yeah, I noticed I love the terminology, like when, you know, when John says lady, you know, lady this, lady that, you know.
True lady, exactly. And we call call each other dear, and that's not in any sort of romantic sense. That's very much a quote from Miss Cleo, psychic extraordinaire. She calls everyone dear, so do we.
And Chris, your little comment there about everyone has the right to hear my opinion, I thought was so, you know, I mean, goodness gracious, you know.
Well, I'm very forward. I quoted that from Madonna. I think I remember her saying that in an interview one time, and I was like, you know what? Yeah, Madonna, that's true. I think everyone is entitled to that right.
Oh, now I gotta say, I also watched a few of your other videos, and first I'm gonna ask you before I get off into this little rant I got here. But you know, is Brian Doyle gonna be with you on any of these upcoming shows?
Oh yes. Brian Doyle is our sidekick, and he's basically with us by the end of the second episode of Chris and John Go to Camp. Starting tonight, you'll definitely see how Brian Doyle works into our lives and how he just basically is sort of an extension of us. So he's definitely along for the ride.
Okay.
He's a good friend of ours, or kind of friend slash frenemy, if you will. He's someone I think viewers will learn to love to hate. And we sort of feel the same way. And he's this outrageous character, and he helps us whenever we need him. So we do love him for that.
Yeah, like the time that you sent him out to sell Christmas cookies.
Right. We're doing this online video blog, and it was Christmas time, so Chris and I made a few interesting concoctions of Christmas cookies. As you'll see through our various seasons, we're not very good at cooking whatsoever, but we made these cookies and gave him the task to sell them, and I think he did a pretty good job.
Yeah, he did a better job of selling them than y'all did of making them. I grossed out
when
I saw what you did with the pickles. I was like, don't ever buy a cookie. If these two gentlemen made a cookie, do not eat it. Do not put it anywhere near your mouth. When I saw the pickle thing, I was like, oh, I was so glad I didn't just eat.
We maybe included pickles in it, but if you watch the second to last episode this season, Chris and I make a wedding cake for a wedding. We were wedding managers and planners, and we give ourselves the task of making the wedding cake. So if you can imagine how we made cookies, just wait till you see the wedding cake.
Oh, no.
And needless to say, it wasn't even so much how bad we did with the wedding cake itself. It's what accidentally happened to it on the way to the wedding. So that's all caught on tape.
Oh, cool. Cool. I mean, and I love the way y'all are just an expert at everything.
<You know? laughs> Yeah, well, I mean, in these days of reality TV, you know, if people are coming to you for help, they want some credibility. So, you know, we have references, and, you know, under the Third Amendment, we consider ourselves to be experts in the fields of pretty much whatever we need to be experts for at that given time.
And so how many casts or operations did that young lady have that you taught how to snow ski?
Oh, Julia. There was a big snowbank at the end of the ski hill. We tried to teach her how to ski for our big Christmas episode a couple of years ago, and we really had no idea what we were doing. She was fine, I believe.
They pushed her down the hill, people. They pushed her.
We figured the best way to do it is just go for it and learn as you go.
Yeah, you gotta go fast, because when we were learning, it was so slow, and we figured, you know, you want some speed. You want to look like those well-produced skiing commercials. Like, you need some speed to what you're doing. So we just, like, give her a little push on the tush, and, you know, she did.
We went off to the spa, and we never heard from her again.
Yeah,
we really didn't.
Till we heard the car's brakes slamming on in the background and the screaming and yelling.
Yeah, luckily, like I said, there was an embankment of snow, so she was protected, but I think she alarmed a few people.
Oh, and Chris, my legs are tired. I was like, oh,
It was exhausting. Like, we had never skied like that before. We didn't even bring proper pants. Like, I was wearing jeans in that, if you noticed. And, like, she was our skiing instructor who was giving us sort of the lesson before we went and taught Julia. She was really, really, really difficult. Like, she probably trained some people for the Olympics. and it was just not a fun experience. It was very tired, this whole skiing situation.
Oh, and then that other part of the Christmas where you made eggnog for the two lovers to try to make their first Christmas so special, and the face on that guy's, the look on that guy's face when he sipped that eggnog, I was like, oh, I must have missed the part where they made the eggnog. I didn't see what you put in it. But
we simply just put eggs in it, right? And we figured nog, which is alcohol, so we just put eggs and liquor, and that was just going to have to
mix it up.
What else do you put in it? Like, who's got the kind of time to, like, Google search?
Well, nog. We just assumed that nog was rum. So we just put, and eggs, right?
Oh, that was too hilarious. And then y'all watching.
Yeah, like I said, you shouldn't get us a cook ever.
Right? Anything. That's basically, you know. And then,
not even eggnog.
And then the makeover thing you did. I just love that you get all your stuff from the dollar store.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we love the dollar store. Everything you ever see. Every episode, we pretty much just utilize products from our local dollar store.
Even
well, just in terms of, like, the production, like, we definitely have to, like, you know, tighten our belt here with what we buy for people, and we want to get the best quality thing we can for our dollar. So we definitely go to the dollar store quite often. That and Walmart. Yeah.
And that, what was that, a Barbie doll you did on the makeover thing? You used the Barbie doll hair or whatever on the back or whatever?
Oh, yeah. Those were the latest, you know, discount hair extensions. We wanted to really spare no expense. So we wanted to make sure
which
that...
Which didn't look exactly realistic, but for the price difference of real hair, it was definitely worth the price of having fake hair.
So basically the catch-all rule for any of the listeners out there would be, if Chris and John say they're an expert in something or they cook anything, just don't believe a thing they say, you know.
Run for your life.
Yeah, all right. Like you did with the rugby ball. Those poor guys wanted their ball back.
Exactly. One thing we can guarantee, though, we may not exactly do exactly what you want, but you're going to have a really fun time along the way anyways. I don't think we've ever come out of any rescue mission where someone hasn't had a blast doing it. So
yeah.
That's why I think the whole point is definitely to make people give them a good time, and whatever they have a problem with, it's to take, you know, take them on a journey and take their mind away from that problem and hopefully a little bit change their perspective from the, you know, from whatever's ailing them or whatnot, but we definitely love having fun with people.
Oh yeah, and I could see in turn they like the lady you did the gay ambush makeover thing. She was just, oh goodness gracious, that she was.
She was honest to God off the street. We had never met her before in our life. We just literally plucked her from obscurity. She's from, I think, South Africa or something. And we just were like, hey, do you want to do a makeover? She's probably thinking, like, we're some, you know, she doesn't know who we are or who we aren't. So she's just all on board, and that's what she got. She got a face full of glitter and some crappy hair extensions.
She was great. But I didn't notice, you know, I mean, was there anything, was there something off camera? I mean, because you made the comment about her, she doesn't know we're not buying these clothes for her, you know, but I mean, you know.
Well, that's sort of one of the tricks of the TV is that you dress them for camera and then you just, you know, you take back the clothes afterwards. It's a big reality TV trick they do in these makeover shows. But we didn't let her know that, you know, she's not going to be taking these clothes home. So she had to sort of, you know.
We did the makeover, then we're like, okay, take them off. This was the first thing we ever did before we had any money whatsoever. So nowadays, I think we would let people keep things like that. But this is our first production. We didn't have that kind of money.
Right. Well, I was, yeah, when you did that thing for Extra, I was kind of shocked that you're like, because that was where, in Vermont, right? I mean, just boom, you went to Vermont.
Exactly. It was a long drive, definitely. Over the season, we've been very lucky. We've got to travel to lots of places, to, like, to this children's campground outside of Pennsylvania, New York City. The camp season is airing tonight. That was in Saugatuck, Michigan, this bizarre little, like, province town of the Midwest. The latest thing we just shot was in Salem, Massachusetts. And so
we've been very lucky. We've got to travel to a lot of really cool gay-friendly places.
Yeah, is that how you found that gay camp at resort place when you were on your road trip?
No, we just started doing research because we filmed at gay campgrounds in previous seasons, and so we were just trying to find the best campground to go to. And then we found this place called Saugatuck, and we found that they had this big gay resort in town with a club and a bar and a cabaret and all this stuff. So we looked at the surrounding area because we also leave the camp a lot of times to do the other things and go dancing and partying and get supplies for the rescue missions and stuff like that. So we had to find a great campground that looked great on camera, that would love to have us. And then we also had to find a campground that had the surrounding area had everything we'd need in order to pull off these rescue missions. And camp itself is only about 2.5 hours outside of Chicago, 2.5 hours outside of Detroit. So it was the correct location.
It's pretty ideal. And tons of fun. Like, we spent the entire summer there. And we were cut off from all of sort of the outside, you know, world. The only time we ever got to watch anything was, like, on CNN at the resort that's down the road. So we had very little contact with what was going on. And it's like 1 year there is like 7 years everywhere else. But that being said, it was amazing, like, just the people and stuff like that. And they're very warm and welcoming. And we definitely suggest, if you're within the range of Saugatuck, Michigan, definitely go there and check it out and stay for a weekend.
Yeah.
I just want to say one quick thing. I'm getting a text message from one of our producers who lives in the U.S. He's throwing a big premiere event tonight in Providence, Rhode Island, at Mirabar Club, which is like the biggest club, gay club, in all of New England. So they're screening the show tonight on Logo. That's the event begins at 7. The actual show is on at 8. So that's Mirabar in Providence, Rhode Island. So definitely check that out if anyone out there is in that area.
Yeah, I saw that. I think you mentioned that on your Facebook page as well. And
exactly.
And you know, I got to give you all both kudos because I noticed you had a couple negative comments on your Facebook page, and you just, like, didn't even give them the time of day, and I got to pat you both on the back for that, you know. Don't
think. We had a long conversation about this last night. We've definitely muzzled ourselves, and we want people to take from the show what they will, and if they have anything negative to say, that's completely their right to do so. But we, you know, we're two young producers, and we've been doing this for 5 years, and, you know, we're 25 and 26 now, so you can only imagine how young we were when we started. And this is, by all means, something we do not for any monetary value or to push a political agenda. It's just something we want to do to look back on and have other people look back on in the future and be like, that was a great, you know, a great show in this GLBT niche market. Well, I mean, we sort of have consciously decided, as we're the U.S. lunks, we're not really going to respond to those kind of things, and we'll let people do that as well. I mean, the show hasn't even premiered yet on those negative comments. I mean, the biggest criticism that's on there now that we get is about how we're too stereotypical or gay, and you know, and you guys straighten up a bit. But you know what? We're not going to change for anyone. We're not going to change who we are to try and help someone's agenda of thinking that if you act too gay, it's setting back our... or actually feminine, setting back all the political movement we've done. But, you know, I think one thing that's fair to say is that our show features every single aspect of the gay community, every single aspect of people in general. We have lesbians people, we have people of every race and color on our show. We have people that are butch, and we have people that could be considered part of the bear community and the twin community. And we consciously tried within the camp season to cover as many areas of the GLBTQ community as possible. So I hope that people tune in and see that for themselves.
Yeah, and I think that's they're the ones that need to lighten up. That's all I'll say about it. You know, that's
good. Thank you.
I got a chat room going on. I'm telling people if they want to put anything in there to feel free to put it in the chat room. I just think you two are just really, really doing awesome stuff, and you're definitely, definitely moving on up in the world. I think I'm really excited for you both to be on Logo. I think that's awesomeness in itself, you know?
Great. Yeah, well, thank you so much. Yeah,
we love Logo because they play Buffy like 24/7 on that network, which is amazing because we love Sarah Michelle.
I know she's airing just like an hour before us. Like, what a connection. We're honored. Like, we're honored to feel so in close proximity to her, even sort of in a syndicated TV programming sort of way.
What, you know, what's this thing that's going to, I saw on the logo site that after each episode, there's going to be this thing on Logo TV that's going to, something about, gimme some more, I hope I'm saying that right. There's going to be a rave and rant, all things Chris and John, after every single show. What is that, a chat or what?
What it is, it's a mini TV show, if you will. It's a web series hosted by two fantastic people who sort of love the show. And basically, every episode after the show, you can log on there, you can watch them, and they're going to be talking to viewers from across America on webcam, on chat, on text message, on Twitter, on email, everything. So after every episode, be sure to go to logotv.com and join them in the conversation. So we'll be talking about the issues of that episode, the topics of that episode. We're going to be laughing at things. We're going to have exclusive deleted scenes. And all the stars of the show are lined up to talk to them and to talk to the fans. So anyone who we're going to be on there. Brian Doyle's going to be on there. Everyone We Rescue is coming on. And so it's just this really fun. It's about 10 minutes long. And I believe it'll be on either tonight or tomorrow morning. I'm not sure exactly when, but sometime after the episode airs, tune in for that.
Huh, that's pretty cool. I didn't quite understand all that, but what it stated on the site, where, you know, but basically they got to be tuned into Logo to see that.
LogoTV.com. I can watch on, like, an online after show, so it won't be airing on Logo TV channel,
oh, okay.
But it'll be on LogoTV.com.
Okay, all right. That's awesome. Oh, man, you guys are good. I hope the show just, I mean, people need to realize, you know, it's comedy. It's fun. It's happiness.
Exactly.
As
our theme song says, life's supposed to be fun, and that's literally what we try to embody within the show itself, so.
Yeah, it's two kinds of camp. It's camping outdoors and campy as in our community.
Exactly,
camp.
Exactly.
Two mints in one.
Great.
You get Chris and John and camp and camp.
Great. So. Well, I should probably take off because we have a bunch of things to do to get ready for the show tonight. But thank you so much for having us.
Yes, thanks for being here, guys, and best of luck to you. And we'll be looking forward to hearing so much more from you both.
Thank you so much.
Awesome.
Like I said, go to chrisandjohn.com and logotv.com. You can find all the detail there.
You two take care of yourselves now, and thanks for coming and joining us.
We'll have to be on again as the show's airing. Definitely have us on again.
Oh, that would be awesome. Yeah, just let me know.
Great.
Amazing.
Thanks so much.
All right, y'all.
Thanks a lot.
Take care.
Bye.
Bye-bye. And that was Chris and John. Oh, my goodness. Those two are something else. I was so happy to have them on the show. And I want to thank all you people out there that tuned into the show. That was total awesomeness. Yeah, I was quite honored to have them, you know. Quite honored to have them for sure. So any of y'all out there, you know, that got Logo TV or access to Logo TV on your local cable network, you can check them out tonight. Yep. Because they're going to be airing on Logo TV tonight. It's going to be their first premiere edition of their show. It's going to be on at 8 p.m. Eastern Time, 7 p.m. Central Time. I didn't see anything about Pacific Time. I did not see a single thing about that. So I don't know what's up with that. I don't have an answer for you there, unfortunately. Oh, goodness. Oh, thanks, George. George is in the chat room. Thanks, George. And Gracie was in the chat room. We had Gaz in the chat room. Alexis Wade was in the chat room. Goodness gracious. Thank you, people. Thank you, thank you, thank you for attending the show. You know, I usually do news on these shows, but goodness gracious, after talking to those two, I'm kind of worn out, to be quite frank. I am basically worn out. Hey, I want to wish you and yours all the best, and much love out there to everybody.
I love you, and you, and you. Oh, and you too, and don't forget him. I love her, and him, and her, and him, and him, and her. I love you all.
Adios, have a nice trip. Bon voyage, farewell to me.
We'll leave the light on for you.